Today we're here with the Swiss explorer, Sarah Marquis. Welcome to the Consulate.
Thank you.
Can you tell us a bit more about yourself and how your journey began to
My journey began like 23 years ago. I started walking, and today I've been walking for the last 23 years. I've circumnavigated the planet once on foot.
Wow. Yeah. And what was your first solo trip like? How did you prepare for it?
So the first solo trip was really interesting. It's actually in the States. I walk on the Pacific Crest Trail from the border with the Canadian border all the way down to the Mexican border. Yeah, it was an amazing trip. It's been really interesting. I had many stories. And it's been amazing.
Wow. And what drives you to go on such daring adventures?
Well, it's a really difficult question to answer really quickly. I think it's a really deep call inside me to go back to nature every time. And my mission, it's actually to link people to nature. So I've got this little world of mine, which is nature, and I've got the human world. And I cross this little bridge between those two and come back and talk about it. That's why actually I write a book.
Okay.
And that's why I do talks. Because I want people to understand that we are linked to the planet. We need to take care of the planet. And we all got the same address, which is planet Earth.
Great. So the book describes the 10,000 mile journey. It's a 3-year trip?
Yeah, correct.
From Siberia to Australia?
Yeah.
Okay. And what's really described in the book? You mentioned nature.
The book, it's an interesting journey, because I use my journey as a main drive, but you go everywhere from there. It's funny, it's light. A lady actually sent me an email yesterday, and she described that like that. She said, "Sarah, I was sitting in my couch, I opened the book, until I actually finished it, I didn't get out of the couch. But what you have to know, it's when it was hot, I was hot. When it was painful, I was painful. And I was surprised that actually I didn't have a hole in my shoes when I come up to the kitchen to get a tea." So I like this vision. It's really like you get with me in the journey and you laugh and you get to those situations with me, which haven't been easy, because as a woman, as a female in those countries like Mongolia and the Gobi Desert and China, so I had few difficulties regarding those countries where I had men on the horse who attacked me at night. I had dengue fever in the loud jungle. I get attacked by drug dealer in the loud jungle. I had all those difficulties on the way, and it's an interesting read. I think I put all my soul in it and all my sweat also, so I hope you're gonna like it.
Wow, that's impressive. And how do you think your Swissness has impacted your experiences? Anything that you bring with you that you've learned growing up in Switzerland?
Yeah, of course, the preparation. I've got 2 years of preparation, and the preparation is it's a really strict preparation. It's a really how I can say that, you really have to look after every detail. A success and a journey like this start with detail. There is a little fine line between success and failure, and it's perseverance, and it's one step at a time, but also you've got the goal at the end of it, and you need to be focused all the time.
Okay, great. And do you recommend the experiences you've had to everyone, or do you think it's for everyone?
Of course. I think it's I'm a woman. I could be anybody. You, me, your friend, my friend, we all the same. We do have all the same DNA. And what I'm here for today is just to be a little messenger and tell you we do have so much tools and strengths inside us all, and we don't really go to look for it. Well, I put few recipes for you in a book to find out.
That's great. And are you already planning your next expedition?
Yeah, I just come back from one where I was dropped in the northwest part of Australia, in the middle of nowhere, in an area called the Kimberley region, and I've been dropped there and survived for 3 months, like the Aboriginal people been surviving for 60,000 of years, living out of roots, insects, fish, and all I can find.
Wow, that's great. Well, good luck, and thank you, Sarah, for coming to join us today.
Thank you so much, guys.